If you do, new versions have increased since I introduced this last time. I would like to introduce it briefly today. Here is the old version. I've already explained about that in the previous video, so I won't go into it. This time here, please click here. Well, copy to drive. It hasn't changed much. In just one group like this. Just put together, compact, put together. Not much has changed since last time. Let's go. Basically, if you push from the top in order, it's okay. First, turn on the mount drive here. Connect Google Drive. The check below. Apply new updates immediately, or because it means which has been updated. I can't say for sure that I don't have a bag. I would prefer to leave this off. Yes, when completed, a green check will appear here and time will appear. Let's go next. What's next? This is basically not done. I won't do it. I don't think it will run. Next, download the base model. Although there are various. No matter what you think you're going to learn. Version of stable diffusion. I think 1.5 is the best. I said many times last time that this is good. When it's anime, I thought something like anything would be better. Actually try. And the underlying model is. I think stable diffusion 1.5 is the best. If you want to use version 2, I think it would be nice to have it in this form. I'll do it with 1.5. The downloaded model goes here when you open here. Here it is. So this is. It is a pattern that pastes the URL of the model by yourself and downloads it. I won't do it this time, download via EE as well. People don't have to say it's unnecessary, but I do. The guy who downloaded via EE goes here. Next, this becomes the data for what to learn. If possible, three letters of the alphabet, if impossible, as short as possible non-existent alphabet, in stable diffusion. An alphabet that will not be duplicated, not a dog. My dog's name, I feel like that. And here is the proper noun for it. Because it's a girl. One girl, dog for dog, cat for cat. Next, run, the other values are fine by default. Unzip, I want to learn here and unzip the others. The data you want to learn is in advance, the number of sheets is arbitrary. In my case, prepare 8 pieces. Zip up that folder and put it in your Google Drive. It will be this. Copy and paste the path. Then it was compressed like this. Image data automatically train rollers. Enter the data. So here, unzip to is unzipped. Since it is about where to put the data, you can leave it empty. If left empty, it will automatically move to the appropriate location. This is from a site like Cardboard. Because it automatically brings the image of the tag. Not this time. If you prepare your own image, do not use this. Prepare your own good images. I think the quality will be better. Next. Now delete any extra files in it. By the way, if you press delete metadata. Extra metadata. It's good because it will also delete it if it comes in. Converter. Do this if it contains a PNG with a transparent background. Since this is a JPEG, I won't do it. Next, now with this item and this item. Automatically add descriptions and tags to training images. This will improve the accuracy of learning, so please do it. The batch size is the number of sheets to be learned by yourself. Please keep the number divisible. I have 8, so it's 8. If you have 7 images to learn, please set this to 7. If it's 6, please leave it at 6 or something. People around 30. I think it's better to keep it as a number like 5. An error will occur if it is too large. Next is here. This is the same for tagging. The batch size explanation is the same as before. Here are the details of the values. Humans, specific characters, objects. For Tokyo Tower or Eiffel Tower. It should be as large as possible, like 8.5. The ambiguous, towards 3.5. Sunset or fog. That kind of thing is this low. For 3.5 or something. This time, it's a person, so I'll do it with 7. This will change the number of tags tagged. Do you tag more or tag less? Yes. Just dip it in. This is the difference between this and this. Captions and text. Looking like this. It will automatically feed you. Use this if you want to add your own tags. You don't have to do it basically. Next. From here we will create a training file. If you chose version 2 as the base model, please press this. If not, you can leave it at the basic default. Then put your project name here. Anything will be fine. So here it is. Stable Diffusion just downloaded. Paste 1.5. And the VAE is this here. Paste VAE. Default after that. Click on the output drive. Like saving the created file to my Google Drive. Please set it. Okay, this is very confusing. As I said last time. Basically the official homepage is 4-in-1. So, try this once, and if it doesn't work, multiply this by a multiple of 8. Well, if it's about this much, I think it's good to stop when you say it went well. If this number is large, file size is getting bigger. There is no point in learning with LoRA, since it is very troublesome to handle. Basically, try with 4-in-1. If it doesn't work, make it bigger. If you increase it by a multiple of 8. In this item, I will return only these two and the rest. Default. I'm talking about how much difference there is in these numbers. This is 2400 steps with 4-in-1. 400 steps of 128 and 128. There isn't much of a difference, or rather there isn't much of a difference. This is 800 steps of 128 and 128. This is 1200 steps of 128 and 128. This is 128 and 128, 1600 steps. I don't see much of a difference anymore. So it's low. Say it's okay. 4-in-1 are fine. That's the story. If this doesn't work, I think you should increase the value and do it until it works. Next is also basic. Remains the default. All are default. It will automatically crop. With the function of automatically upscale and downscale. With the function of, it's a function that makes the cache feel good, so this is still the default. Is good. It will give you a good feeling. My learning data. Next. Next is this. Make 0.1. You can set here as epic or step. It doesn't matter which one, I don't care. I think the steps are easier to understand. If it is a step, enter 1600 steps or whatever you like. 25 epics is fine. This time with 25 epics. The number of images at the batch size is divisible by, I have 8 cards, so 8. But where is it? This number will use a lot of GPU if the number here is large, so will result in an error. If so, change this to a smaller number. People who are in paid Google Colab, 4-in-1 can be executed with a batch size of 8. This is the limit. Conversely, if this is set to 128, if it is 128 and 128, an error will occur if it is not 4 here. So change it to every in epics here. Change it to every in epics. If you go back and set this to 5, it will be saved every 5 epics. Save to my drive. The rest is okay by default. Start with the finished LoRA. It will be saved in LoRA's output in my drive and drive. I tested the model I made last time with this test. I guess that doesn't give very good results. What to do here? If you actually use it in automatic 1111, the way it comes out is a little different. The person who actually does it is the automatic 1111. I think you should start it and give it a try. Say you can do it here, you can't, if you actually let it start automatic 1111. There were many things that seemed completely different, so I think it's better not to use this. That is, farewell.